Welcome to the Outlab Getting Started video. In this video, I'm going to show you the FRA impedance spectroscopy procedure. First, open library. In the library, you'll find the default procedures. Select the impedance spectroscopy and select the FRA impedance potentiostatic. The procedure is opened. The default FRA impedance potentiostatic procedure provides an example of an electrochemical impedance spectroscopy measurement in potentiostatic conditions. The potentiostatic mode is selected at the beginning of the procedure using the Outlab control command. So in the Outlab control command, you can select between potentiostatic or galvanostatic. But in this case, it's potentiostatic. We apply 0 volts with respect to a reference electrode, switch the cell on, wait for 5 seconds, and then we do an impedance measurement of an FRA measurement. First, apply a frequency from 100,000 Hz to 0.1 Hz. We can modify these type of frequencies. So we can set up, for example, I want to only go to 1 Hz, for example. And the number of frequencies per decade is at this moment is set to default to 10, but you can modify it to any value you want. The number of frequencies per decade used in the frequency scan, or the number of frequencies used in the frequency scan, this property depends on the frequency step type property. So the frequency step type property, it's now set to points per decade, but you can also select for a linear distribution between 100,000 Hz and 1 Hz, or a logarithmic distribution between 100,000 Hz and 1 Hz. And you can select how many frequencies do you want to have in between. Also, the amount, of course, gives you an estimate of the duration. So if you select 100 frequencies between those two with a logarithmic distribution, it will take 247 seconds. But if you only take 10 frequencies in between, then it only will take 25 seconds. So it depends really on how you define the distribution of the frequencies. Normally, it's points per decade, and then we can set to, let's say, 4 points for 4 points per decade. And it will take 52 seconds. The amplitude is set to 10 millivolt root mean square. And root mean square means that you can, or you can select between the top of root mean square values. Use RMS amplitude, and RMS means root mean square. Then we have the wave type. You can set single signs. Normally it's set to single signs, but for lower frequencies, you can also select 5 signs or 15 signs. So there will be on a base frequency, there will be superimposed 5 additional frequencies or 15 additional frequencies. Depends on what you select. But normally you apply 1 frequency at a time. And the input connections is internal, which means that specifies if the measurement should be carried out internally through the potential set or externally using the external input provided on the front panel of the FRA32M module. So these are the settings. But there are some additional properties. Unlike other measurement commands, which common additional properties, the FRA measurement command has specific additional properties, which can be accessed by the More button. So click More. You'll find the sampler, options, plots, and a summary. In the summary, you will see how the frequencies are distributed. And in the sampler, there is some basic functionality and some advanced functionality. I'm only going to discuss the basic functionality. Because the advanced functionality, you have to look in the user manual for the details about that. So the basic functionality of, for example, the maximum integration time is defines the longest time in seconds during which the AC response of the cell is recorded for data analysis. Long integration time values increase the duration of the measurement, but improves the signal-to-noise ratio. The default value is 0.125 seconds. Then you have the minimum number of integration cycles. This defines the minimum cycles of the AC response to record the data analysis. And the minimum value is 1 cycle and the maximum number is 16. Integrating over a large number of cycles increases the duration of the measurement but improves the signal-to-noise ratio. This value must be an integer, which means 1, 2, 3, etc. The default value is 1. You can also sample the time domain. This defines if the time domain information should be sampled during an FRA measurement using the provided toggle. The time domain information consists of the raw potential and current sine waves. This information can be used to build a Lissajous plot or to evaluate the signal-to-noise ratio and to verify the linearity of the cell response. The time domain, potential AC and current AC, and potential resolution and the current resolution signals are added to the data for each individual frequency when this option is on. You can also sample the frequency domain. This defines if the frequency domain information should be sampled during an FRA measurement using the provided toggle. The frequency domain information consists of the calculated FFT results obtained from the measured time domain. The frequency domain information can be used to evaluate the measured frequency contribution. Then you have sample DC. Defines if the DC component of the two input signals, potential current or external signals, information should be sampled during the FRA measurement using the provided toggle. This option is active by default. And you can also calculate the admittance. That's the inverse of the impedance. So these are the basic settings. So I switched on the sample time domain. In the options, you can select increase the current range. So the highest current range is 100 milliamp and the lowest is 10 nanoamps for this 204 instrument. In the plots, you can define where you want to see the plot. In plot number 1, you see the Nyquist plot. In plot number 2, you see the Bode plot. But you can also switch on the resolution versus time or the Lissajous plot. And that can be in plot number 3 and plot number 4. And then we have the summary of the frequencies. So here you will find frequencies. If you want to delete frequencies, you just select a line and press delete. You can delete as many frequencies as you want. You can also add ranges. So for example, you can add a range, for example, from first frequency, let's say 1 hertz to also 1 hertz. I'm only using 1 frequency and I have to have it in 5 signs. Add range. And you'll see that this frequency will superimpose 1 hertz, 3 hertz, 5 hertz, 7 hertz and 9 hertz on top of a 1 hertz base frequency. So we have 5 signs shot in one go. That's the multi-sign option. Okay, this is my summary of my frequencies. I've connected the dummy cell to connection number port C. So the working and the sense electrode is connected to the C connector on your dummy cell. And then we can start the measurement. It will roughly take 52 seconds. And you can follow what's happening on the frequencies by looking in the command tile. So we're now at 10 kilohertz, 5.6 kilohertz. But with the F10 button, for example, F10, you can also see what the how much time it takes and what kind of frequencies you're measuring, and also the DC value of each frequency. Yeah, so you can follow in real time what's going on the cell. So now we're at the last frequencies with 5 signs. And here we go. So this is my measurement of the impedance. For more information on properties and procedures, I will advise you to go to chapter 8.6 in the user manual. Thank you for watching Getting Started video.